Now that's what I call an impressive performance. The symphonic band delivered right off the bat, giving us an incredible beginning for our concert.
就是嘛，我们管乐团那么厉害，表演也当然有声有色。这是他们努力不懈地练习了很久才得出的成果。
我也认为刚刚的表演实在太精彩了，令人回味无穷，想一看再看。
不过
不过
大家也不必担心，接下来的表演同样精彩。
Well, I guess it was kind of good, but I believe we still have a lot more to look forward to. After all, the night is still young.
The night is still young indeed, but let's not dwell too much on the previous performance. We still need to introduce our next performance.
不如在介绍下一个表演之前，我先出个谜语，让大家猜一猜吧。长着小蛮腰，生来肩上扛，一碰会唱歌，你们猜这是什么乐器？
That must be a small instrument. Can you give me some hints?
Stephanie, 如果给提示的话就很容易猜了。那好吧，这类乐器是和接下来的表演息息相关的。
是乐器中的提琴家族吗？让我想一想，小蛮腰，肩上扛，啊，难道是小提琴？
说的没错，小提琴身形像葫芦，一共由30多个零件组成，是接下来表演歌曲的核心乐器，占据着非常重要的席位，更算得上是整个乐团的支柱，同时也是一种高难度的拉奏乐器呢。
Yes, indeed. Many friends have complained how hard it is to play the violin. That's why I prefer playing the cello.
看不出来呀 ,Stephanie, 你竟然还会拉大提琴。
I totally agree with what she's saying. I mean, look at her. She's so cute and tiny.
Hey, get off my case.
Stephanie, 那你为什么不参演今年弦乐团的演出呢？
Well, firstly, I'm the MC of the concert, you know, I'm standing here. Moreover, everyone in the string orchestra has profound skills and excellent performing techniques, which is why I do not have a place there.
Don't worry, Stephanie. I know for a fact that it is a great pleasure standing next to me. You're always welcome here on stage with me.
Stephanie, 你还挺谦虚的嘛。不过说的也是，他们的确个个技艺高超，不仅如此，他们还经常要留校练习呢。
你们说了那么多，观众已经迫不及待了，接下来的节目到底是什么呢？
The next performance is the Four Seasons. Speaking of which, I have a riddle for you guys. What do you call a dog on the beach in summer?
夏日中在沙滩上的狗，不会是热狗吧？
Oh my god, I thought my jokes were lame.
Hey, I was just trying to entertain the audience.
Nicholas, 难道你有更好的笑话吗？
Of course, I'm the master of jokes. So, listen up, right? What did summer say to spring?
我不知道啊，难道是悄悄地你走了，正如你悄悄地来了？太难猜了。
It's actually, help, I'm falling.
You're indeed the master of bad jokes. Okay, enough about the jokes right now. How about finally introducing our next performance?
当然了，下一个节目是由弦乐团为我们带来维瓦尔第的著作《四季》。
The Four Seasons is actually a set of 4 violin concertos composed by an Italian composer named Antonio Vivaldi. It is a classic and beautiful piece of music.
Now that you mention it, I actually know this Antonio guy.
什么？你真的认识他？
Yeah, I mean, I even know what he's doing now.
Well, what is he doing?
He's decomposing.
Enough with the gags, God! I have a feeling it will go all night long.
我也觉得有点冷。可是说到古老，这首作品有一点很特别的地方。它于1725年问世，是维瓦尔第15岁的时候 献给波西米亚伯爵的一套大型歌曲，和声与创意的尝试，合称四季。
这绝对称得上是维瓦尔第先生的代表作。他的音乐淳朴自然，从巴洛克时期开始，这首曲目一直广为流传。此曲最为特别的地方就是每首协奏曲风格各异，各自代表一年中的不同季节呢。而在这其中还有一个故事呢。曾经有一个传言，如果有人听了四季之春，万物就会在你心里生长开花。
这听起来还挺梦幻的呢。今晚的音乐厅正需要这种生机勃勃、万物回春的景象。第二个协奏曲《夏天》歌曲在最后的乐章如同雷鸣一般，所以后人普遍将这一乐章称作“雷暴”。而与其搭配的14行短诗也是音乐史中头一个出现的呢。
Well, without further ado, the College String Orchestra presents the Four Seasons.
Thank you. Thank you. you.